I done ran into this lady several times and always enjoyed her, and I'm sure you all will. So what I would like for you all to do, I'm messing up on words. What I'd like for you all to do is start putting your hands together and give it up for comedian Heather Hatton. No, excuse me, celebrity comedian Heather Hatton. Give it up for her. Come on, give it up. Heather.
Hey. I know, I'm trying to change for you. How y'all doing? Y'all still got these people not showing up? Ooh, baby, I'm gonna get them. I'm a fast on them. Be like, now, Lord, now. You know, it's the difference between fasting and trying to put a root on them. I cross that line from time to time. Okay, I want y'all to know my name is Heather Hatton. And I'm not one person that brag, but I am a person who I do believe in, you know, what God has blessed me. So I have actually, you're looking at a Black History moment because I am the first Black woman to ever make the choice, be number one with a comedy album. Hey, get it. But anyway, so y'all feel free to Google me if you want to. But I want to tell you, you know, sometimes you got to have the spirit of separation when it comes to people. I'm real spiritual, I'm down to say that. Everything needs a spirit. So, stop buying the devil, not while I'm talking. So, get my other phone. I believe you need to, you know, give people a level to get to you, and that's me. I got four phones, four of them. I got some mess with, some talk tos, and some for shows. Yeah. See, the mess with, get this number here. Right. My baby play at this phone, I might answer this phone once a year. So you know, if somebody be like, oh, I got a problem with Heather. If you don't have my direct number, you don't know me well enough to have a problem with me. See, you got to give people different levels to you when they messing with you. Now, my other phone, I done left back there. Now, that's a talk to. You a little bit more than a friend. I still don't mess with you like that, but I'ma see you on a trial basis. See, you can't reach me from the country, so it's not reach. You can't reach me directly to me. See, so that's the other phone. I done left it back there, but I got it. Now, my God mama right there, she got the main phone. That's the one mom and daddy and Jesus and the children have. Now, if you got an 832-439 number, that mean I rock with you. Now, that don't mean you can call me anytime you get ready. Because even with that phone, depending on how I rock with you, you can't call me after 7. I don't know you like that. Some of them got, see. Yeah. Some people can't call me after 10. I don't mess with you like that. Now, some people can call me anytime after dark 30. Now, yeah, dark 30. It ain't even time. It's just dark 30. You call me at dark 30. Now, you know you got that one good friend where she call you. It don't matter what it is, and she can't even get it out her breath that something wrong, and she just, baby, I got a friend like that. Now, we've been friends for about 10 years. You got to be in that double-digit category, right? Not these little 5, 7, 6 friendships. No, I don't know you, because if we could be out somewhere and somebody want to jump on you, I ain't going to jump in, because I don't want to interrupt your karma, because I don't know what you did before I met you. You know, I don't want to intervene and go out trying to show you a lesson. See? You might have stole from somebody or slept with somebody's husband, and you do that good thumping. So, you know, I don't want to intervene when the Lord tried to teach you a lesson. I ain't going to do that. But that good friend that called me about 1 o'clock in the morning, now she knows she can't call me up with no man. Like, I ain't finna blow up nothing because you done called him cheating. This girl, this is the 4th, 5th time. Go on, make you a tuna sandwich and go to bed now. He ain't going to change. Just go. But if she called me about something else, baby, she know as soon as she, I got the shower curtain, the shovel in the back. Where we going? I watch too much CSI. See, some people watch CSI to learn. I watch CSI to get away with some things, baby. Hell, always wear a wig. Ain't no dealing in this wig, baby. Huh? Yeah, y'all trying to be natural, hell. Okay, you gonna be the first one to get caught up with something. Peruvian ain't got no DNA. It's not coming out the scalp, bitch. Yeah, and let me tell you, natural health or something. Let me tell you something. That don't make you no more woman than me because you natural. Let me go and put it on not that, because your ovaries is just like mine, okay? When it's time for a blood transfusion, nowhere on that do it say, natural hair. Uh-huh. And while you out here with the picket line, natural hair, why you ain't telling everybody how expensive that stuff is? Yeah, I tried natural hair. My hair filed for legal separation from me. We didn't get along. So I had to go back to my lie, which is perm. I don't care. Yeah, cause see that natural hairline shampoo be $14. And see my net, see, uh-huh, she knows she's shaking her head. And just cause you buy it don't mean it's gonna work on your hair. So now you got to go back to the beauty supply store and buy some more $8.99 cause you trying to be natural. That don't mean that's gonna work. But let me tell you, that old school TCB, $1.99, baby. Hell, I'm gonna tell you what the Lord love, but y'all trying to be natural. And where's some of you beauticians out here? If you some real beauticians, you wanna be silent. Yeah, I got the microphone. I'm gonna tell you, if you a real beautician and your clients don't have no edges, I'm gonna need you to retire yesterday. Yesterday. Not yesterday, yesterday. Yeah. And see, I have learned, I know we got some people out here, just because you passed that little paper exam don't really make you no beautician. That just means you know how to pass the paperwork. They know how to bubble in the right answer. And why come every time you get people that have hair, it's the difference between clipping and cutting. We don't want our hair cut. Can you just clip the ends like you say? They want to clip the ends and charge you $10. I ain't asking my ends to be clipped. That's fable. That's failure. God led you to clip my ends, and he led me to tell you I'm not paying. Yeah, I ain't coming here for no clippage. The baby, see, let me tell you something. This baby here done made me proud, honey, because he walk around in them shoes, and I could, come here, let me tell you something. I don't want me, baby. Baby, this baby ran a 100-yard dash up there in them same shoes. I say, Lord, bless his ankles. Bless him, Father. Okay. All right. Hope y'all enjoy me. If you didn't know, well, I'm sucking anyway.